Recording in progress.
Hi guys, good morning all of you. Guys, audible? Okay, right. So yesterday we started constants. And in this check constant we discussed in the last session. Check constant at column level. Okay, how to define column level as well as at a table level. and later we said one point here. So when we apply constants on multiple combination of columns, that the type of constants are called as a composite constraints. Okay, for example, so we applied unique on multiple columns, then composite unique, composite primary key, composite check, composite foreign key, so etc. So this is table level and column level we discuss. But in this unique constraint, what is the problem here? It is restricted duplicate values. Okay, so that was the restriction here, but unfortunately accepting here nulls. Okay, so now these nulls, okay, how we can restrict means, the next one is called as a not null constraint. So not null constraint, basically this constraint we are using guys here to restrict it. To restrict null values. So you restricted nulls, but here also having drawback is what now, but accepting duplicate values into columns. So not null constraint, not null in the name only there. So nulls are not allowed. Not null. Nulls are not allowed. So this is not null constant restriction of your nulls. The whatever nulls are accepted by unique constant, so that we can go to avoid it here. Or we can go to restrict it. Okay, right. So, but here not null constant guys here. One very important point is what it can apply, it can be defined at the column level only possible, at column level, but not table level. So not null constraint, what is the nature of this means? It can be defining at column level. So column level only I can use it. But at table level, I cannot use this not null constant. Okay, now only column level. Okay, now you can see. So the example of column level. Now we can see. So now I'm creating one sample table. So create table test number 3. Okay. Suppose EID on this EID, I'm going to apply not new and ename. So we can apply bracket to offer some size. And here also not. So every individual column, we applied your constraint and to execute it here. So your table successfully created. And later, when we insert the data into this table, okay, so EID 1021, ename is Smith. Okay, now I execute. So one row successfully we inserted this, and that row data we can see in our table. So yes, 1021 and Smith. The same information when I come back to here. Okay, so the same kind of for the same data 1021 and Smith. The same data if I insert it one more time, it will be accepted. So that means what is it, guys? Here it's a duplicate values are accepted here. So 1021 Smith, 1021 Smith. So duplicates are allowed. But when I try to insert a null values into these two columns, for example, a null and some name is passing Jones. But your EID column is having your not null constraint. And so we are inserting null value into EID column. Then when if I insert it like this, so it was showing that I cannot insert null into so-and-so table and ID column. So EID column, we cannot insert. In the same pattern, guys, here, suppose here I'm passing 1023 or 22, and the name I'm passing null. But here also not accepted and cannot insert null into test 3 and ename column. So here what happened, nulls are restricted, but duplicates are accepted. This is not null constraint working nature. This is not null constraint column level. But when I try to check out your table level, for example, if I want to go for table level, then what happened, we can see. So not null constraint at table level, we cannot use it. Not null constraint at table level, we cannot use. For example, I try to create one new table. Create table, the test number 4. Test number 4 of. Now I'm passing EID integer and ename. So varchar 2 of some size. And end of the table definition, we are passing not null and EID comma ename. Guys, audible. Okay, right. So this is what now. So column table level. So table level, it is not supported. Okay, not supporting at your table. So these are what now, guys, your unique and not null, okay, constants. But if you want to see unique and not null, in unique constant, when I was applied here, so the problem of unique is what now? Accepting nulls. In the same to same, the problem of not null is what now? Accepting duplicate data. So the both constants are having their individual problems. So unique constant is going to be drawback is nulls are accepted, and not null drawback is duplicates are accepted. So the both are having, okay, its own drawbacks here. So to avoid this both problems, okay, we can use what now? Primary key. We can use what now? Primary key. So primary key, okay, what it was telling us here, first of all, observe. Primary key is called as a, it is a combination of unique constraint plus not null constraint. So that means whatever the unique plus not null constraints natures are there, like restrictions of duplicate, restrictions of null natures are there. Those two natures are having by primary key. That means the two natures combination it was having. So by this reason, the primary key is having the nature of unique and the nature of not null. So by this reason, what it was happened, when we applied primary key on a particular column, what it was happened, it restricted, okay, primary key column, it is restricted. So duplicate data, that means duplicate values plus null values also restricted. Duplicate values plus null. So the both duplicates are not allowed, as well as nulls also not allowed. So that means the problem of unique and not null, we can overcome by using of what? Primary key. So once you apply primary key, the duplicates are restricted. That is one advantage. And along with the duplicate, nulls also restricted. Okay. But this primary key, okay, when we apply on your table, it's one of the very important point. A table is having, a table is having only one primary key. Okay, only one primary. So that means previously, not null, I was applied here, multiple not nulls we applied. So not null we applied on ID column, not null applied here ename column. That means multiple not nulls we applied. The same to same, unique constant also, when you come to here, unique constant is also we applied multiple unique constants we applied on a table. And even though check constant, even though foreign key, even though default, you can apply. But whereas come to primary key will not be like this. Okay, no? Primary key will not be like this. So the table should accept only one primary key here. Okay, no? So on a single table, we cannot apply multiple primary keys. We cannot apply. We can apply only one primary key on one table. One primary key on one table. Okay. But more than one primary key constraint, we cannot apply on a table. Okay, now we cannot apply on a table. So why, sir, why this particular, this primary key only having this kind of nature means, sir? Yeah, the reason is called as a primary key, actually, okay, it is called as a candidate key, we called. primary key is also called as what now? Candidate key. So every table should have a only one candidate key per a table. Okay, so candidate key means it's a superior. Okay, it is a superior. That means is the super key. Superior we called. Okay, so he's like a what we can say in our general our language is like a boss. Okay, so he's like a boss. So compared to all constraints, primary key constant is like a boss. He is a superior. So every table is having only one superior key. Okay, one super key. Okay, now. So one candidate key. So that means superior means what? No, the main important key constant. That's called a superior record. That's why primary key constant very, very, very oftenly the people are using in their database tables. Okay. But only one primary key on a table because of reason, the primary key is like a super key. Primary key is like a superior. Primary key is like a boss. Okay, so every table is having only one boss and remaining all are their employees, just like, okay, so just your understandable format I'm telling. So that's why any database, even though SQL server, okay, any database, so a table is having only one super key or a table is having only one superior key and that is called a primary. And primary key, even though we called as a candidate key, also we called. Candidate means the main important key column in a table. Okay. And that is called a primary key. Okay. But in a single table, more than one superior keys are not accepted. In a single table, only one boss. One table, one boss only. But in one table, two bosses, not possible. Okay, now in one table, for every one table, only one boss is there. But on a table, we can't apply two bosses. The two bosses will not having here. Okay, now so that is like a primary key. Okay, right. This point should be remembered. It's very important for you. A table is having only one primary key constant. One table, one boss only. A table is not having more than one boss. Okay, na? More than one superior is not having. So a table is having only one superior key. Okay, na? Right. So now this is what the primary key nature. And let you see this primary key. First, I will show you at column level and later I will show you table level. Okay, right. So column level, for example, come to your column level. Okay, so now I'm creating one more table. So create table test number 4. Suppose product code integer and here I applied primary key and product name, okay, varchar 2 of 10. And suppose here also I applied here primary key. And now tell me guys here in my table, now how many primary keys I applied here? 2 primary keys I applied. One is primary key on my P code column. One is primary key on my product name column applied. So you have 2 primary keys are there. Primary key number 1 and primary key number 2. But as per rule of a table is having only one boss and one superior key only accepted. The 2 superior keys are not allowed here. So now we can see who executed this one. It was showing some error. And the error also, it's clearly telling us, see, so you don't want to any confusion. So your error is also very important. Yes or no? So error also, if you carefully read your error message, then you can easily understand. Okay, right. Your error is clearly telling us, see, how much clarity was given in the error message. Table can have only one primary key. See, this is the clarity. Okay, now, so I don't want to tell anything. Your server only telling, your Oracle database server only telling to us, what it was telling to us, table should have only one primary key. Okay, now, it's a clear error message.
Okay, right. So that's why what you understand here, every table is having only one superior key only accepted. More than one superior keys are not allowed. Okay, so one table, one boss. That's it. But one table is not having more than one boss. Okay, no? So in such a way you can understand. So now here, okay, fine. So now what I want to do, whatever the two primary keys I have applied here, so in this two primary keys, any one primary key you want to remove. Okay, any one primary key you want to remove. That your wish. Okay, right. Now I'm going to take into removing one primary key from my product name column. And now I just force. Now tell me how many primary keys are there now in my table? Only one primary key. So only one primary key was having and one superior key, and that will be accepted. Okay, right. Now after accepting this, now I want to insert some data into this table. That's number 4, sending value. So P code, okay, 1021, and product name is C. Okay, now. Okay, so now, so 1021 and C, this is my first record. This is my first record. So first record will be accepted, nothing problem. But when come to insert into test number 4 and values, okay, now, so now for example, 1021 and C plus plus, I'm going to insert it here. Okay, now. Here, what it will happen, 1021, I'm inserting into P code column. But 1021 already existing in this column, right? Already existing in this column. So that's why what it was happen, the same number we are inserting. So it was showing error. It was showing error, and the error, what it was telling, unique constant is violated, and so on. So key identity number. So yeah, why is a unique constant is violated, it was showing means, we already knows that primary key is a nature of a unique plus a not null. So primary key is a combination of a unique plus not null. So that's why whenever you want to insert in duplicates, then duplicate related constant is what now? Unique constant. So that unique key is going to be violated. That means firing. Okay, now that is what. In the same to same, when I'm sending here, null I'm sending now for my C++. But null is also not allowed because it was telling cannot insert null. Okay. So that means your primary key nature is what now? Okay. So now what I'm going to do? So here, not null is not going to be accepted here because the not null constant nature is also having by primary key. Okay, no? So now these are the unique and primary key, unique and not null combination. The primary key is going to be working now. So that means we restricted duplicates and also we restricted null values. And finally, when I'm going to insert here 1022 and I'm passing here C plus plus. Now we can see it is allowed. And when come back to your table, okay, test number 4. So the duplicates are not allowed, nulls are not allowed, and allowed only unique number of or unique number or unique values only allowed. Okay, now? So this is what? So this is primary key constant at a column level operation. At a column level operation. Now come to table level. So when I come to table level, okay, what it was happening, you can see. In table level, so we are applying your primary key. So in table level, it is create a table, the table number, test number 5. And now I'm taking here, suppose, P code, integer, and a product name, I'm taking here, varchar. welfare 2 of compliance. And what I'm going to do here is the end of the table definition, we applied a primary key. Now tell me how many primary key I'm using here. Come on, guys. I was given how many primary keys here? Only one primary key. So only one primary key constraint I'm using, because every table should have a only one primary key. So one primary key is okay. So one primary key I am applying on multiple combination of columns. Point understanding, na? Only one primary key. Here only single primary key. The single primary key we are applied on the combination of columns. Okay, na? So, but don't think it is a multiple primary key. This is only single primary key. In my table definition, how many primary keys are there? In my table definition means I have only one primary key. And that one primary key constraint, are you applied on how many number of columns? How many number of columns are you applied, guys? Come on. How many number of columns are you applied? Yes, two columns we applied. Okay, na? Right. Now tell me, whenever you want to apply a constraint on multiple combination of columns, then what we called? Come on, guys. When we applied your constraint on multiple combination of columns, the type of constraints are called as a composite constraints. Very good. Composite constraints. So that means this is composite primary key. So composite primary key is also very, very important in your normalization technique. In your normalization technique, composite primary key, composite unique, these are very, very important for us. Okay, right. Now we can see. So primary key we applied on multiple combination of columns. Okay, fine. So now after that, I'm inserting some values, and I think you all of you know how it was working. Already I explained yesterday, unique constraint, composite unique constraint, I already explained to you. So same like this here, observe. 1021 C language accepted. And this data is successfully inserted into your table. But the same record, same combination of data, now I'm inserting. What happened, guys? Is it accepted or not accepted? Same combination of data. Is it accepted or not accepted? Not accepted. So why it is not accepted means it is a repetition of data. It is a repetition of data. So we all of you know this. When composite constraints, when we applied on a multiple combination of columns, then combination of duplicates are not allowed. So here it is not allowed. But when I'm inserting here, 1021 C++, I'm inserting. So this combination can I allow? This combination can I allow, guys? Yes, definitely. So definitely we allowed, because it is a different combination, it was allowed. So now suppose if I'm passing 1021 C++, the same repetition of combination can I allow? No, this is not allowed. Again, the errors are coming out. Okay, now, but here, for example, in the same, if I'm inserting null comma null, when I'm inserting here, so null comma null is also not accepted. Okay, now, so null comma null is also not accepted. So finally, so your primary key constraint in the test number 5 to execute now. So this is the way the different combination of data only allowed, but same combination of data is not allowed. So this is same as a unique constant, how it was working as here, same to same, your composite primary key also. Okay, now, right. So this is primary key working API. This is primary key. And the next constant is called as a, so check constant, okay, the purpose of constant, what it is here means to check or verify the values, okay, to check values, okay, values with user defined condition, with user defined condition, okay, with user defined condition before accepting into column. Before accepting into column. So any value, when they want to insert a particular value into my column, so that value, first of all, we need to check it, whether it is valid or invalid as per the user given condition. So whatever the user was applied condition on a column, that condition will be checked here. That condition will be checking here. So if that condition is satisfied, then the value will be accepted. If the condition will not satisfied, then the value will not be allowed. So this is the purpose of your check. Check constant means checking values before accepting. Okay, right. So now this check constant, okay, same as we can apply at column level, and also we can apply at the table level. At column level, and also we can apply at the table level. So now you can see, first I will show you column level. So in column level, okay, so now we can observe. So I'm creating one table, create table test number 6. Here I will take here, suppose employee ID integer, and you're taking employee salary, it's a number. Number of 10 and check constant. So now I'm passing salary, which is greater than 5,000 rupees. Okay, salary which is greater than 5,000 rupees. And now, along with this, suppose I'm giving some location. So where care to of some size. And on this location also, okay, I applied here check constant, check of LOC. In of, so I'm giving here HYD comma Pune, I'm giving now. Okay, right. So here, okay, this is my table, first close, second close, and third close. Third closing. Okay, this is our table. So now on two columns, two conditions I was applied. So one check condition we applied on salary column, and salary column should be accepting more than 5,000 salary only accepted. More than 5,000 salary only accepted. And the LOC column, location column, I was given only two locations only accepted. So HYD and Pune. So that means other than these two locations, if any other location are you inserted, if any other location are you inserted, then that location is not allowed. Okay, right. This is what we called as guys here, check constant we applied. And now let you check out. Now I'm inserted. Insert into test number 6, sending values, ID number 101, salary, I'm giving here 5,000 rupees salary. And now location is Pune, I'm giving now. So tell me guys here, this is accepted or not? Come on guys, this raw data is accepted or not? And whatever I'm inserting, those values are satisfied as per given conditions or not? Check out. allowed or
no?
It is not allowed. Why, sir, it is not allowed here means the reason is what now? Salary is greater than 5,000, we are asking. Salary is greater than 5,000, we are asking. But here, I am using exactly 5,000. So 5,000 is greater than 5,000. Condition true or false? Condition false. So it is not allowed. Okay, na? And location Pune. So Pune location is there. So that means this is true. Pune location is there in my condition. So this is true. But where it is problem, salary is problem. So that's why it is not allowed and your check constraint is violated. Your check constraint is violated. So guys, here we cannot. In the same pattern, suppose I'm inserting here 101. I'm passing here 6,000 rupees. Okay, then I will send here Hyderabad. Now, can I insert guys here? Can I accept Hyderabad and 6,000? No, we cannot accept. Why we cannot accept, sir? Why we cannot accept, sir? Because of reason. Yeah, the problem is what now? Whatever the location, check condition, location, whatever I was given. Here, my spelling was is what now? HYD format I was given. I was given my location Hyderabad is which format? HYD format. But are you inserting entire the spelling here? So your salary is satisfied, but this entire the spelling will be not accepted. So here also it was showing error. Understanding na? Here also it was showing error. Okay, right. So that means exactly whatever the conditions we taken off here, so those conditions exactly we need to follow. Okay, right. So now we can see, now I'm passing here. Okay, so 101. And now, yet 6,000 rupees, and I'm passing HYD. Now tell me, now all conditions are true now? Now all conditions are true now? Yes. So now it will be accepting here. All conditions are here, so that the data successfully accepting into my table. 6,000 and HYD only accepted. And one more thing, for example, other than 102, I'm passing here 7,500. Suppose I'm passing here, for example, Kerala. If I'm passing Kerala, can I accept this? No, because Kerala is the Kerala location. Is not there in my condition. In my condition, I was given only Pune, Hyderabad and Pune, but I'm sending Kerala, so it is also not allowed. So salary 7,500 satisfied, but location name is not satisfied. Suppose if I want to send now 102, the 7,500 and I'm passing Pune, can I accept this? Yes, we can accept because Pune location was there in my condition. So it is accepted. So finally, if you want to come out and see your table, the test number 6 is okay. So now this is the data we have it. Okay. So now this is what we called as the check constraint to checking values before accepting into that particular column. And whatever user condition was given, the user defined condition, whatever it was given, that user defined condition values must and should be checked. Then it will be accepted. Okay, right. Come to your table level. In table level operation, you see guys. Okay, so I'm creating one more table. That's number 7. Okay, now we can see. In table level operation, Now I'm taking, as usual, suppose employee name I'm taking. So this is varchar 2 of some sites. And salary I'm taking here. This is number. Okay, fine. And comma. At the end of the table, so I'm applying here. Click on the check off. What I want to do here, employee name is equals to, here I'm passing lawyer of employee name, okay. And later I'm passing end operator and salary, which is greater than or equals to 8,000 rupees. Salary which are greater than or equals to 8,000 rupees. So now I need to, these are the two conditions I'm passing. This is internal check condition and outer query condition. So now here, okay, the check constraint with multiple, okay, here one condition, this is ename is equals to lawyer of ename, end operator, and this is second condition, okay? And this is table level operation we call right here. This is we called as table level. But in this table level, carefully if you identify, okay, now. So now I'm going to inserting some data into this. So insert into test number seven and sending values here. Sending values of, suppose name I'm passing Sai. Okay, and amount of salary I'm passing here. Okay, 8,500. Now tell me guys, this record is accepting or not? Has your conditions are satisfied or no? No. So which condition is not satisfied, guys, here? First one or second one? Ename condition is not satisfied. Ename condition is not satisfied. So that means ename, I'm asking lawyer of ename, I'm asking. But here, Sai is a capital. So we are sending Sai is a capital. But our ename is asking lawyer name. But are you sending capital? So first condition is false. But guys, second condition true na? Yes or no? Second condition true na? True. But in between these two condition, which operator I'm using? End operator. End operator means what? Both conditions are true. So both conditions are true, then only true. If any one condition is false, then it is a false. So that's why when I send this, it was showing error. When I send this, your check constraint is violated. Okay, so this is what. In the next level, for example, I'm sending here. In the next level, Sai sending his characters. Amount of salary 7,500. I mean, so now this time what happened? First condition true, second condition is false. First condition true, second condition is false. So again, it is also not allowed. Now I'm going to give here Sai and 8,500. I'm giving now. Now tell me guys, here both conditions are true. Yes, first condition true, second condition is also true. So true, true, true. So that was, it is accepted. True, true, true. Okay, so now it was accepted. So finally, when you come back to your table, test number seven, and you check out, so Sai 8,500 will accept. Okay, now? So this is called as a table level operation on check constant, how to apply. And this kind of constant, even though we called as a composite constant also we call. Okay, now composite constant also we call. Okay, the next one is called as a foreign key. The next one, foreign key, or foreign key, even though we called as a references key also we can call. Okay, so come to foreign key. So foreign key, okay, what is the main purpose of foreign key? And why we want to use foreign key means, the reason of foreign key is here, simply we want to say, to make a relationship, to make relationship between tables. So this is simple, the reason foreign key. So foreign key is used to, foreign key is used to making relationships in between table, in between tables. So this is the first purpose of foreign key. But whenever you want to making relationships, okay, whenever you want to making relationships in between table, so there are few basic rules we have it here. And that rules compulsory we should satisfy. So when we satisfy the rules, then only we can say your relationship is correctly and accurately it was established in between table. Okay, na? What is the basic rules are there? Let you see. The basic rules of foreign key when you want to use or when you want to apply, the basic rules are we need to find out. First rule is what now? Okay. In between which tables do you want to, okay, creating relationship? In between which tables do you want to creating relationships? So those tables between compulsory we should have a, or else we have, okay, we have a common column, a common column name. But name is not a mandatory, it is optional. Okay, name is not a mandatory, it is optional, but it is recommended. Okay, now so it is a optional but recommended, because of reason why the people saying recommended means easy to identification of this. Okay, now, so for example, let you see. Suppose you have some tables. So test 1, test 2, okay, test number 3, and test number 4 we have there. There are 4 tables we have it here. There are 4 tables we have it here. Okay, now, suppose in between 4 tables, different names are we are taken out. Is it possible? And it is also what we can say supported. But different column names, if I'm taking, what it was happening, you can see. For example, serial number, SR number, SRNUM, SNUM. Whenever you want to taking different column names in different tables, and based on the serial number, suppose you need to making relationship, then the user will be getting some confusion here. That means it's a complex to identify, okay, so what is now identify key column means the main important column. So it is complex to identify what is my main key column in the relationship. So what is the main key column in the relationship? So that is complex means difficult to identify. So that's why the people, what they will do, instead of taking the different names, so they will be take a common name. Okay, so they will be take common name. So what is the advantage here? It's easy to identify. Okay, my key column. So what is my relationship key column is there, the main column. That is very easy for us. So this is the first rule is telling us, okay, so you should take, okay, it is not mandatory to take a common column name, but it is recommended for us. Okay, right. Next one is what now? Okay, we must have same data type. Okay, what are the common column? Otherwise, I can say. So whatever the common column is there, common column data type must be matched. Okay, must be matched. Maybe column names are matching or same name or not. That is a optional, but we should have a data types. So which is your test one and test two? Okay, which is your key column or common key column? So that data type must and should be same. Okay, that data type must and should be same. Okay, na? So you can accept like this. Otherwise, you can accept like this. Okay, so you can accept like this. Okay, and here also LOT, varchar. Okay, na? So this is accepted, guys. Same data type, it will be accepted. But it is not like, here I applied here integer, and here I applied here, suppose. Okay, I applied here varchar. So this is not allowed, it was showing error. Okay, now the first two are can be, but third one we cannot do this. Different data type columns cannot be making relationships. Okay, now right. So this is one. And the next point is what now, guys? Okay, the next point is here. When you creating relationships in between the tables, okay, when we creating relationship in between the tables, okay, one table should have the primary key, okay, and one more table, the other table should have a foreign key. So it's a compulsory. One table should have a primary key and one table should have a foreign key. So when it was having like this, then relationships are, we can go to created. But here, one point is what number? Here, primary key column and foreign key column, okay, must be which column? Common column. Primary key column and foreign key column must be which column? Common column. It means what, sir? It means, see, I'm giving examples also for easy understanding purpose and with for confusion. So now these are the two tables, okay? In two tables, suppose if I apply serial number here, so any one column, it is a primary key, and the same common column, it should be foreign key. Okay, this is the mean of your third rule. Okay, now, right. And the next rule is what now? Primary key table is called as what we call here parent. Okay, parent table. And foreign key table is called as child table. So that means whatever the relationship we are going to be created in between the tables, the which type of relationships we created means it's a parent and a child relations we create. It's a parent and a child relations we created. Okay, na? Right. Now, the next point is what now? Okay. Foreign key column values are R and P column values are must be must be primary key column values only. Okay, na? So this is one more important point. What is the error? Foreign key column values must be primary key column values only. Okay, na? Now, it means what, sir? It means what, sir? For example, test one table is there. Test two table is there. So in test one and test two, carefully observe. Serial number, suppose it's a primary key. Serial number, this is a foreign key. So these are relationship columns in two tables. Suppose in your primary key column, we have your serial number 10, 20, suppose then 30 was there. So this is primary key column values, 10, 20, 30. So whatever the values we have it in the primary key constant or primary key column, whatever the values we have it in the primary key, same value should be there in the foreign key. So that means 10 and 10 and 10 and 20 and 20 and 30 and 30. So these are allowed. These are allowed. But here somebody is asking doubt. What is the somebody's doubt? Sir, your primary key is having only unique data. That means primary key is not accepted duplicates. But your foreign key, we are inserting 10, 10, 10 duplicate data, 20, 20 duplicate, 30, 30 duplicate. So while, sir, okay, while, sir, means, so this kind of doubt is there. Only the reason is what now? Primary key table, what I called as guys here, parent table. This is parent table, right? This is parent table. And this is child table. So now in parent table, how many parents I was stored here? How many parents details I stored here? 3 parents details. 10 is the one parent details. 20 is the one parent details. And 30 is the one parent details. So in parent table, there are 3 parents details are I stored. And this is child table, child information I stored. But tell me guys here, a parent can have a multiple children. Come on, in your real life, I'm asking, a parent can have a more than one children's. Yes, of course. That is a common point. Okay, a parent can have a more than one child. More than one child. For example, if you go to our grandmother, grandfather generations, okay, if you go to our grandmother, grandfather generations, in any family, okay, maximum 5, 7, 8, 10, 11, 12, these many children are there in our grandma, grandfather generations. I hope you know that. So 3 uncles, 4 aunties. 4 aunties, 3 uncles. Okay. So like this are big families. In grandmother, grandfather generation, there are big family. So in a family, almost 7-8 children are there. Okay, na? So in our grandmother, grandfather, okay, in their generation, in every family, minimum 5 to 6, minimum 5, minimum 7, minimum 8, or somebody 10 also, 10, 12 also. So that means here, why this example I'm telling means you can understand the concept. That means a parents can have a many children. So there is no limitation of the children. There is no limit of the children. So any number of children can be have here. But in come to our generation, what happened? Only one child or maximum 2 child. So yes, I know so many. Okay, in my grandfather and grandmother, there are total 11 children. in my grandfather and grandmother, total 11 children. So see how much big families are there. So now that is water. But okay, so here means the point is what? Now what we want to take the point here, a parent can have a many children. That's why a 10 is a parent, right? This 10 parent is having how many children here? 10 parent. Come on, guys. 10 parent is having how many children? 3 children. Like a 20 is a parent, he was having 2 children. Like a 30 is a parent, you're having your 3 children or 2 children. Okay, right. So this is the concept. That's why a parent can have a many children. That's why many children are accepted here. Okay. But here, suppose if I just inserting in 40, if I try to insert 40 child information in my child table, but tell me guys here, 40 child parent is there in my parent table? No. So 40th child parent is not there in my parent table. So that means this value is valid or invalid? Yeah, this value, it is a invalid. And invalid means what it was happened here, it was showing error. Okay, na? So this is what. So we can, that's why we are telling. So foreign key column values must be primary key column values only. Okay, na? So that's why 10 is accepted number of times. 20 is accepted number of times, 30 is accepted number of times. But when I'm giving 40, the 40 is not allowed and it was showing error. Okay, na? Right. But here one more very important point is what, no? But when I try to inserting null is accepting again. Null is allowed. Why, sir? Anybody guessing? Null is what we discussed in the early classes. What is null? Null is a unknown value, undefined value, okay, which is not equals to, okay, so not the, okay, unknown value, undefined value. Okay, now, which is not equals to zero, which is not equals to space. Okay. So that means null come to in the relationship. Null is called as a, which type of value means? Null is called as a orphan value. So what is the mean by orphan, guys? What is the mean by orphan? Come on. What is the mean by orphan? Here, orphan means so many people in our common language, what they will say, no parents. Okay, no? Orphan means no parents. But that is wrong. Don't say no parents. That is a wrong. Okay? Because one thing just observed, without parents, child is possible? Not possible, na? So orphan means he is also child. Okay. So he is a child means definitely this orphan child, parents are there, na? SR, no. Orphan is also one child here. He is a child means definitely his parents are there. Yes, parents are there. But who is that? We don't know. Parents are there. Parents are there somewhere. Somewhere parents are there. But who is a parent? Who is exactly parent of this orphan child? That we don't know. But parents are there somewhere. Okay, na? So that's why here also concept is what now? Null is an orphan. That means this null is also one type of child. Orphan child we call. That means this child is also having parents. But the parent who is that, I don't know. The parent who is that, I don't know. But here my parents are having 10, 20, 30. So that means maybe in the future, this orphan child parent may be 10. There is a chances, maybe 10, maybe 20, maybe 30. So that means in the future, this orphan parent may be any one of this. Understand my point? Any one of this, either 10 or 20 or 30, but any one of this. So that is compulsory. This orphan parent is any one of this, 10 or 20 or 30. But exactly who is that, we don't know. Exactly who is that, we don't know. So 10 is a parent, no, we don't know. 20 is a parent, no. 30 is parent, no. So exactly who is that, we don't know. But someone is his parent. Someone is his parent. But who is that? We don't know. So when we know, that's a depending on our situation, we can identify. It's a depending on the situation, we can identify who is exactly the parent of this null orphan. Okay, now? So that's why null is accepted, guys, here. Okay, now? Concept understanding, now? Why, sir, null is accepted means null is an orphan. Orphan means having parents, but who is that exactly parent? We don't know. So maybe his parent is 10, maybe his parent is 20, maybe his parent is 30. Okay, any one of them. Okay, so in the future we can identify. Okay, that is one reason. Second reason is what now, guys? Yes, second reason is what now? One more reason also there. What does that mean? By default, foreign key column, or foreign key, by default foreign key column, is allowed. Column is allowed. Duplicate and nulls. That is a default nature of foreign key. This is one more reason, guys. Why foreign key is accepting duplicates and null means it's a default nature. So every constant having its own rule and nature. So how the natures we said, unique constant nature is what now? Accepting nulls, not accepting duplicates. Not null nature is what now? Accepting duplicates, not accepting nulls. Primary key nature is what now? Not accepting duplicates and nulls. So like a foreign key nature is what now? Accepting duplicates and nulls. So by default, foreign key is allowed duplicate and null values. Okay, now? So that is also one reason why foreign key column is accepting duplicates and nulls. Okay, now. So these are the total, the points, whatever we discussed. These are the basic rules and basic okay, the things we need to remember whenever you want to making relationship. So whenever you want to making relationship, compulsory, we should remember these basic rules. Okay, na? Right. So in this basic rule, as it is, we should follow to work with your foreign key constraint. Okay, na? Right. And later, finally, suppose this foreign key, if you want to apply. So what is the syntax to apply foreign key? Okay, na? So now foreign key, Okay, now how to apply means, suppose this is your column name, and as usual, we are applying data type for this column. And if it is required size, size. Okay, right. And after that, we are applying here. The references key, I'm using guys. So your references is nothing but foreign key. So references. So references are you taking from? So from where are you taking your reference? Are you taking from? From which table are you taking your reference from? Parent table. So your parent table name I want to give. In parent table, which column data are you taking as a referenced column? Means what now? Primary key column. So here I want to give a primary key column name. So this is okay. Foreign key, when you want to apply on a column, then this is what our key reference. References is called as a foreign key. Okay. And we are taking references from parent table of which column? Primary key column. Okay, now. So this is the syntax to apply your foreign key on your table columns. Okay, right. And now, as per this syntax, and we will see examples, and those examples we will see in tomorrow session. So tomorrow we will go for to check how to preparing your relationships and how these all basic things we need to follow. Okay, so that all we can check out in tomorrow. Okay, na? Right, guys. Thank you. Thank you so much.